Today I'm going to be showing you how to synthesize a house sparrow sound from scratch. I will be using Phaseplant, Cubase and RX, but the main concepts will be applicable in other software. A good place to start off is to find a reference sample you want. I have this recording I took a while ago. I'd now load up your spectral analyzer and import your reference sample. So what we can now see is a visual representation of the sound of the sparrow. While the house sparrow sounds a bit like it makes one note, we can actually see that it kind of has a pitch ramp upwards, then downwards, and then up again, and then down again. So what we need to do is to replicate this pitch change in our synthesizer. So I'd now load up your synth. I use Phaseplant for this, and one thing I like particularly about Phaseplant is that you can do fairly easy additive synthesis, which is very useful for matching the exact harmonic content of each bird. The way to do that is to use the wavetable generator. And what this allows us to do is we can come in here, and if we go to this pencil icon, we can now draw in individual harmonics of the bird. But what we want to do is to make sure that these harmonics match the harmonic content of the sparrow. So let's go back to our reference sample. And in order to learn the harmonic content of the sparrow, we should first select a point in the timeline where the sparrow has strong energy. And then we can go to spectrum. Now we can see the loudest parts of the frequency spectrum, and these are likely to be our harmonics. In the majority of cases, we'll find that the loudest frequency is also the fundamental frequency of the bird. So that means it's the first harmonic. So here we can see a fundamental frequency of roughly 4,000 hertz. So what we should do now is go over to our synth and add a harmonic which has the same decibel value that we can see here. So our first harmonic should have a value of around minus 13.4. That's about here. And then let's repeat this for at least the first three harmonics. To get the level of the second harmonic, we need to double this frequency, which, so in this case, we're doubling 4,000 to get to 8,000, which is around about this peak here. So that means we now want minus 43 decibels. And then the third harmonic is around about minus 55 dB. Your most important harmonics are going to be the first three, and beyond that, they typically become less and less significant to the sound. In this case, we can see the fourth harmonic isn't a whole lot quieter, so we can add that as well. So that's around about minus 57. And because the following harmonics don't contribute to the sound as much, you don't need to be quite as precise with them. So I would just draw a line which fades down to minus infinity. What we can now do is bring this sound to a louder volume, which we can do by going up here to the Fixes tab, and then we can normalize the frame peak and it'll do this for us. We now have quite a basic sound. One thing we don't need is for the pitch to be tracked with the keyboard. So one way we can do this is to set the harmonic scale to zero. But now we'll get silence because it's effectively playing a sound of 0 hertz. So what we need to do is to find the actual frequency of the sparrow's call. And I would, in this case, I'd find the lowest frequency it ever calls. So back in our spectral analyzer, I would get a selection tool, typically the paintbrush here, find the lowest pitch, which is about here. And now we get a readout down here of the frequencies. So the lowest one is about 2,500 hertz. So we can now type in this shift one, 2,500. And if we play a note on the keyboard, it's always going to be 2,500 hertz, regardless of what key we press. Now what we need to do is to make sure that the frequency of our synth patch resembles the frequency curve of the house sparrow itself. As we'll want the timing to match as well, I would first select the whole duration, so roughly like this, and then we can also get a readout of the length. So this top one here is the length of our selection, so that's around about 110 milliseconds. So what I would now do is add a curve in Phaseplant, and if we type 110 milliseconds. We have a curve that lasts the correct amount of time, but it doesn't do anything. What we now should do is draw the pitch curve. We need to effectively draw this line in our synth. This is going to be difficult to get perfect, So I just get it as close as you can and then keep adjusting it until it sounds best. I would then go back into RX and find the highest frequency that the lowest harmonic ever reaches. So that's here. And we can get a readout. That's around about 5,200 hertz. So we should click this plus on the curve and then right click shift here. If we type here, we can type in the highest frequency we want. So that's 5,200 hertz. Now, if we play a note on the keyboard, it should vaguely resemble the sparrow. But what you might notice is that I can hold a note and it will just keep playing. To fix this, I would first copy this envelope we've made. We've now got an envelope with the same length, which we can use to control the volume. I'd set the level of the wavetable to zero. Then I would assign our second envelope to control the level. I'd right click and type in 100%. Now we can press a key on the keyboard. And we're always going to get the same sound, which resembles a sparrow. It's worth noting in Phase Plant that the envelope here can allow us to create notes that are too short if we tap the key really quickly. But what we can do is instead use a curve and make it something more consistent. Now I can press very short notes on the keyboard. And it's still going to allow the note to ring out for its full duration. There are a few ways you can take it further. One thing you're likely to want on a bird is a bit of reverb, which you could do separately, or you can do it in Faceplant, so I'll do it here. I like to have a very low mix, so I'm just going to put in 2 of the default reverb. And tweak the size and decay a bit. There's a little trick I like to do sometimes, which is to use a convolution plugin to add in a bird sample. So I'll drag that in here. And we can load as IR in Convolver. And I'd set the mix low again, and I'd find a short snippet of the sound, add a fade out, and a fade in. Adjust to taste. And this isn't quite as game-changing as you might think adding a sample is, but what it means is we can still customize the synth patch as much as we like, and it still adds a slight tonality of a real bird sound. And something that's worth doing now is adding a bit of randomization to it. So I'd add in a random modulator, and what we can do is set its frequency to 0, and this means it will only pick a random value whenever we press a key. And we can use this to control a few different things. So for example, we can map this to the frequency shift. It's now quite extreme, so you often need very low values here. You could also assign the randomizer to change the duration of your curves. And again, minor changes here are key. And there we have a fairly realistic house sparrow sound.